Hey guys, what's going on? Paul here. Welcome back to another Cardano video. And in this one, we're going to talk about what will the Cardano Vasil hard fork bring to the Cardano ecosystem. So lots to talk about. When will the hard fork happen? We know now that is September 22nd, with the changes coming into effect on September 27th. But lots of people are still wondering, what will this actually do for Cardano outside of people saying this is going to be great for Cardano? In this one, I'll try and break it down fairly simply what it actually is. If you get value, please do share it out. If you think others can benefit, I do appreciate that. Give the video a like, comment questions, or even comment Cardano Vasil down below to help with the algorithm. Thanks for watching. Let's jump into it. Okay, timestamps will be down below. And first off, I'll start off with my interpretation of Vasil, what it's going to bring to Cardano, and then we'll get into how it's actually going to bring that into the Cardano ecosystem. And I have recorded this video a few times, but I found that I got lost in the technical stuff, went too deep into it. So I'm really going to try and keep this on a high level, but I'll provide links to the different material down below for people who want to dive deeper. And there are lots of technical presentations out there as well. So all about Vasil. Vasil comes into the Basil phase of the Cardano roadmap. And if you look at the roadmap here, you can see Gogan was what we got last year. Smart contracts came onto Cardano. But as we know now, that really was a very early version one of smart contracts for Cardano. So Basil is all about scaling, all about bringing improvements to smart contracts and also bringing improvements to the chain as well in terms of scaling and where we can take Cardano into the future. And that's what a lot of Vasil is bringing. So version one of smart contracts let some DeFi, we've seen NFT marketplaces launch, we've seen smart contracts out there, we've seen some DEXs as well, but the more complex DeFi hasn't really got to launch on Cardano yet because some of the main requirements that they needed weren't there yet, but they are coming in Vasil, especially in the, there's three SIPs. I've talked about them here a lot before and we'll get into them fairly soon. They are really going to bring a lot of improvements. So what I expect from Vasil is to see a lot more dApps launching across the Cardano ecosystem over the next few months. It won't be 27th of September comes when the changes actually kick in and things start launching straight away. We might see some, but it is going to take a bit of time before other ones launch there as well. But I do expect them to start coming. Money markets, we see the likes of Indigo bringing synthetics, we see Maladex are talking about a completely new model for DEXs, and lots of different applications like that as well. So as well as complex DeFi coming, we should also see huge improvements in the optimization of Plutus as well. So it's going to make for a lot faster transactions in terms of interacting with smart contracts, a lot smaller transactions due to some of the SIPs, which mean you don't have to include the script in every interaction with a smart contract, which brings the sizes down and also brings the cost of interacting with smart contracts way, way down as well. And I will show you an example from Artano as well in a second. So they would be the big improvements, as well as throughput as well, because when you remove, even as simply as removing the scripts from transactions with smart contracts, when you pull them out, them transactions are a lot smaller, they take up a lot less room in blocks, and that means you can get far more transactions into the blocks as well. Pipelining is coming in as part of this as well, and that's really setting a lot of the foundation for input endorsers, which I haven't seen when we are going to get them yet. But let's actually jump into the features that it's going to bring. Actually, even before that, I'll just show you this article here. This is from Artano, which is an NFT marketplace on Cardano, and it's over on Essential Cardano. I'll put a link to it down below. I'm not going to go through the phases here because I'm going to talk about the features in a minute, but this is the main thing I wanted to talk about. So this is them comparing Plutus V1 Alonzo era, doing a buy on the marketplace to Plutus V2, the Babbage era. And this was done on the preview testnet with node version 1.35.3, which is the one for mainnet for the hard fork as well. So figures will be similar, maybe slightly different, but we'll see once mainnet actually launches. Okay, so if you look at the direct sale and NFT buy, the transaction fee here on the current setup that we have is 1.68 ADA, and the transaction size is over 6,500 bytes. When you look at Plutus V2, which is going to come in fairly soon, the transaction fee is brought down to just under 0.4 ADA, a massive 76% reduction in the actual cost of that transaction, and the transaction size You can see a huge difference in that, down 90, nearly 93%, down to 481 bytes. So as well as pulling the script out, there are other optimizations there, but you can see the size would also have an impact on the cost, because a lot smaller transaction is going to be cheaper in cost as well. And in terms of auctions, you can see fairly similar decreases as well, with 77 and 93%. So where are these actually coming from, these changes? Okay, pipelining or diffusion pipelining. So there is another article here that IOG put out a while ago. I'll put a link to that below for anyone who wants more information on it. But this is all about speeding up how quickly blocks are propagated across the network. So right now we have one block every 20 seconds with Cardano, and they need to be propagated across the network within 5 seconds. So pipeline diffusion changes slightly how things are done. If you look at down here, pipeline or diffusion pipelining propagates blocks before their full validation, thus overlapping the time spent on diffusion with the time needed on validation. Also ensures the block header referencing the hash of a previous block is propagated correctly. So there is more to it than that very high level, but I will let you have a look at that. But when you hear of pipelining, basically it's about getting the block propagated across the network. And this will really come into effect when we get input endorsers, where John Woods talked about it in Cardano 360 in April. He explained what input endorsers are actually going to be, and I will put a timestamp down below to that. It's around the 41 minute mark in that interview. But he explains where currently we have one block every 20 seconds, but they're going to bring in more frequent blocks into it as well. So the block every 20 seconds from then on won't contain transactions. It will be the consensus block, and the blocks that come in between them consensus blocks, which are every 20 seconds, will be the ones that will include transactions. So when you start getting more frequent blocks, it will be even more important to get them blocks propagated out across the network as quick as possible. And when you have more frequent blocks, you can fit far more transactions into the network as well and get them submitted a lot quicker. So again, that's all part of scaling, but that definitely is something for another video. So Plutus script enhancements. These are the three SIPs that you will have heard a lot about, either on my channel or on other channels as well. So reference inputs then, SIP 31. So this is one you will have heard a bit about already, I would say. So this upgrade enables data sharing on chain. So previously datums were carried in transaction outputs. So they're stored and provided access to information on the blockchain. So you had to spend the UTXO to actually use the output of it or to read the output. With the change that is going to come in now with reference inputs, this facilitates access to information stored on the blockchain without the need for spending and recreating the UTXO. So as well as taking extra unnecessary transactions out of the network, which means there's more room for normal everyday transactions as well, it also really improves for applications, Oracle's been one of them with DeFi, when you just want to read a value and use that in your own script as well. So really good improvement for DeFi. Inline datums, so transaction datums previously attached to outputs as hashes, and with inline datums, developers can now create scripts and attach datums directly to the outputs. So again, this is more for the developers and how easy it is for them to pull information out as well. So again, I won't get into the technicals on it. Lots of other areas out there for it. Reference scripts, this is the one that brings a lot of the big improvements as well. This is where you don't have to include the script in every transaction when you're interacting with smart contracts. It means you can pull the script out and you can just reference the script somewhere else, which, as we've seen with Artano, significantly reduces transaction size, improves throughput, and reduces script execution costs. So when you look then, we have Plutus V2. So V1 was smart contracts. Plutus is the language for smart contracts. So Plutus V2 brings a lot of improvements. I had all of this highlighted. I'm not even going to go through it. What I will say is I'll touch on some of it, bringing in lower cost model parameters than before, resulting in 20 to 30% improvements in script resource usage, better interoperability with other blockchains such as Bitcoin, Ethereum, from the cost model parameters. And then as well as that, developers will be able to see redeemers for all inputs. You know what? That's even getting too technical. We won't get into that. But here is a point as well about why The hard fork happens on September 22nd, and the 27th is when the changes actually kick in as well. Since a new cost model is needed to enable Plutus V2, Plutus V2 capabilities will become available from the epoch following the Vasil hard fork. So that will be September 27th. Other enhancements then, script collateral adjustments. So again, anyone who's used to interacting with DEXs or NFT marketplaces on Cardano knows that you have to set collateral in your wallet, which is at least 5 ADA sitting on a UTXO on its own. So previous to this, if something actually happened and things went wrong, then that 5 ADA would be gone. You don't get anything back. But with the changes that are coming in here for collateral adjustment is, after Vasil, dApp developers will have the possibility to specify a change address, so it means that any remaining funds from that get sent back to the change address. We also have improvements on currently there before Vasil, block validation required 2 VRF functions in every network hop. Vasil drops one of these functions, resulting in faster block validation and network syncing times overall. So again, all about getting blocks out to the network quicker. So I know for some people this mightn't have been technical enough, and hopefully for the majority it has been enough to let you know what Vasil is going to bring to Cardano and a little bit about how it's going to bring. So in summary, cheaper transactions in terms of DeFi and interacting with contracts, your general ADA transactions like sending ADA or native assets or NFTs from one wallet to another. I don't expect any major differences there for now. Anyway, we'll see what happens in the future. The costs are more on the actual interacting with contract side, but the throughput on the network should be a lot better. I know right now things are down a bit with the bear market, but once things start to pick up again, you will really see the benefits of smart contracts not taking up the majority of blocks. And as more and more DeFi launches, there's going to be far more activity on chain. So all of that extra space in the blocks, along with pipelining, getting the blocks out there quicker, is going to bring some major improvements. Thanks for watching, guys. I do appreciate it. Hopefully this has been of value. Subscribe if you're new, share it out, comment questions, give it a like. I'll talk to you soon.